All right, so this was the question that came through. I am having trouble putting it all together, reading a question and figuring out what to do, and cardio issues. Can you go over cardio? Well, what I decided to do was take a couple cases, and these are real cases redacted with people that have cardio issues. And just show you how to abstract the information, what to look for when you're going to be coding a case with somebody in cardiology. And these may not be just cardiology, you know, they could be a practice, but they actually are cardiology cases. So the very first one is she's coming in for her yearly checkup, and as I peruse this encounter, I tend to always go to the bottom and look, go up from the bottom, because when you're doing risk adjustment and stuff, part of that is an auditing aspect. You have to make sure the signatures are all valid and so on and so forth. But what I do is I'll come down here and I want to know what the assessment is. And so the assessment is the diagnosis. Sometimes it'll say diagnosis, sometimes it'll say assessment. And so now I know this, he's assessing that this patient has right renal artery hyperplasia, they have hypertension and palpitations. Okay, and then I can look here real quick and say, yeah, sure enough, there's a plan of care that addresses all of those. So those are three codes that I know I'm going to be looking at. So I go back up and let's see what's going on with the patient, see if there's anything else that we can capture. Well, right here on the first one, I see left ventricular diastolic dysfunction secondary to hypertension. Okay, then we have fibromuscular hyperplasia of the right renal artery. Okay, we knew we were going to code that. Hypertension and mild hypercholesterolemia. And then I look at the medication. Sure enough, now when you're doing risk adjustment and HCC coding, you have to draw a line. So if I see something that's going to be a diagnosis, I want to see if there's a medication. That's the easiest way to draw a line. But on top of that, you're going to go down here and say, okay, this is the history that they're taking. Blood pressure's mentioned. The patient has palpitations. That's mentioned. These are words that leap off at the page at me. Also, we see that they took the vital signs, which is probably always going to happen. But again, that tells you that the person has a hypertension, or you have a backup that this is being addressed. And then when I go here, I'm going to look at all of these, and this is where you're going to see a lot of no, you know, stuff. But cardiology, if this is a cardiology patient, then there's probably going to be something here that's addressed. And so everything's normal except for right here, they've got trace ankle edema, and people that have cardiac issues often have swelling in the ankles and edema, and so that right there is a red flag that we have cardiac issues going on. There's other reasons to have edema, but cardiac's a big one. So then I get down here and I say, okay, I'm not seeing anything else, and then confirming right renal artery hyperplasia, hypertension, and palpitations, and then so those are the ones that I'm going to code first. Now I went ahead and put these out. This visit was going to get a 99214, or that's what it did get. The hyperplasia of the renal artery is 447.3, but I figure a lot of you didn't know what hyperplasia of the renal artery was, so I pulled that definition, and it's really when the cells on the inside of the heart, they're kind of going crazy. They're abnormal and they're overgrowing the inside of the heart. And the heart is a, you know, it's a really interesting tool, a muscle. And you go messing with any part of that perfectly shaped and perfectly formed heart, then you can have problems. Palpitations, definitely had palpitations, 785.1. And then hypertensive heart disease, benign without heart failure, is 402.10. Now, you might ask, what about the cholesterolemia, the hypercholesterolemia? But if you notice, he doesn't ever address that. And you don't code off a problem list, okay? It has to be addressed. It has to be partially the reason why they're there, and the is one of the reasons that you're coding, and I would say regular coding. Now, if this was for risk adjustment, I could code that. You know, a lot of people won't let you code off a problem list, but he's on Crestor. So I know, you know, yeah, it's actively being treated, and a lot of them will actually date the date that they're getting their refill prescription. So, you know, again, that's addressed. But otherwise, it's not addressed anywhere else here, and it's not going to be coded for that reason. It's not addressed down here in the plan either.